This Nuki smart lock is faulty and has no power. I picked it up for 90 bucks on eBay. We will dig in and see if we can bring it back to life, shall we? Let's see what we received in the package. We are greeted with a manual and further instructions. We skip this entirely. That's the important part, the smart lock itself. We can move the knob, that's a good sign. In the previous generation, version 1 and 2, the motor inside fail often. When this happens, the knob is hard to turn because the latch mechanism won't work properly. I've done a video about this in the past. What's inside this little box? Nothing. What about this one? This is the mounting plate for the lock. We don't need this because they are backward compatible and I have an older Nuki mounted already. It's time to get rid of the packaging and get to work. Let's do a quick test to prove that the device is completely dead. We remove the battery holder first. Let's grab 4 AA batteries and check them. A good battery has approximately 1.5 volts. Now the rest of the batteries. Long story short, the batteries are full. Great. We will place them in the battery holder according to the printed scheme. The battery compartment itself looks fine. It's time to insert the batteries in the Nuki smart lock. As you can see nothing. No lights or anything else. Let's start the timer to understand how long it will take to fix this little friend here, hopefully. To open this bad boy, it is enough to grab a Phillips head screwdriver. We see one screw on the backside of the lock. Let's remove it. Inside the key slot, we can see two more screws. Let's remove them also. Afterward, we can remove the front part of the knob. There are no electronics inside this part. Let us poke the screws out of the housing we just loosened. To remove the daughter board, we need to remove the three screws. Lift the plastic part and we do see the LEDs underneath. Wow, what a rhyme.
Have I made a rhyme?
Let's open it like a book and we will see a ribbon cable connecting it to the internals of the smart lock. Now we carefully open the little brown latch and the daughter board can be freed. The fault will not be on this board, it looks outstanding. Let's remove some more screws. There are two more screws in the top left and right edges. We must remove the rounded part by pulling it off to get to the main PCB. The next one is the large rounded key holder. Let's grab the whole inner part and pull it out. Nice! Time to grab our trusty microscope camera for further visual inspection. Let's first remove the ribbon cable from this side for a better view. After opening the little flap, it is still in place due to the white tape underneath it. Good, now we can have a look at what is wrong. I see something fishy. How about you? Let me grab a tweezer to check. This needs to look better. Why is it so crooked? A little push with the tweezer was enough to turn this part into a satellite in orbit.
Oops.
As you can hear, I was pretty surprised about this flying component. Let's take a closer look. The legs are a little bit bent, but the rest looks good so far. So I'm hopeful that we can solder the component back in place. By the way, it could be an SMD transistor. We use flux, always use flux when soldering, it helps the solder flow. In addition to the flux, please always use a fume extractor when soldering. The fumes are very nasty, you don't want to breathe them. With that said, let's apply fresh solder to the joints. Nice, time to place our component. Now let's align it properly. That looks good. What do you think? Let's solder it back in place. The solder we have already applied to the joints is not enough to solder it back in place. We need to apply more solder during the soldering process itself. Come on, Markus, you can do it. Almost there. I could have realigned it a bit more, but in the end, it doesn't matter. Soldering of the component is almost complete. To remove the flux, we use a cotton swab and some 99% IPA, aka isopropyl alcohol. After this, we separate the cosmetic tissue and use a thin layer to soak the rest of the flux with the help of a brush and IPA. Nice! Time to grab our multimeter in diet mode to see if we get a voltage drop as we measure each leg of our soldered component. Let's check each leg. As you can see, the multimeter shows a voltage drop for each leg. This is a good sign. Hopefully, this component was the cause of the no power problem, but let's quickly see if anything else might be suspicious. The rest will pass the visual inspection. The larger solder joints look good and pass the poking test. Just to be sure, let's put some fresh solder on these big boys.
You're playing with the big boys now! Big boys!
You guessed it. Flux. Look how shiny the joint looks with the help of flux. Yes, I know, but I can't stress this enough. Shiny. Give it our usual cleaning procedure as mentioned before. Perfect. We are ready to get it back together. Let's carefully open the latch of the ribbon cable connector and insert it. Close the latch and the ribbon cable is seated in place. Very nice. For further assembly, the ribbon cable has to be maneuvered through the small slot. Let's put the screws back in to secure it. Time to re-insert the round key holder. It is a bit tricky to insert. Slide the round cover back into place. The next step is the daughter board. The ribbon cable needs to be reconnected. Insert it slowly. And carefully close the brown. Ah, come on. Is this now a new thing of mine? Fixing one thing and destroying something else? Let's see if we can put it back together under the microscope. With the help of the tweezers, we try to reinsert it. I said we are going to try to reinsert it. You know what, before I get mad, let's try an alternative solution. We could either replace it with a new connector or develop a more creative way to fix it. I have no new connector, so let's be creative. As you can see, the ribbon cable sits in the right position. We need a way to fix it permanently. Let's use this double-sided tape and cut a small piece of it. Something like this. Peel off the foil and try to insert the ribbon cable without getting stuck by the tape too early. Let's press it down firmly. To secure it even more, we place black tape above the connector itself. We should be good. Time to screw the PCB back in place. Okay, it is nearly back together. Is everybody ready to get the batteries in this baby? Awesome! We have a white ring of light and we hear that the motor works as well. Both motors. Have a heart for broken devices and see you next time. Bye! 36 minutes, not bad.